Zinc deficiency can occur in soil, plants, and animals. In animals, including humans, it is defined either qualitatively as insufficient zinc to meet the needs of the body and thereby causing clinical manifestations, or quantitatively as a serum zinc level below the normal range. However, serum zinc is not a reliable biomarker for zinc status in humans, as a decrease in serum concentration is only detectable after long-term or severe depletion. Novel zinc biomarkers, such as the erythrocyte DGLA ratio, have shown promise in preclinical and clinical trials and are being developed to more accurately detect dietary zinc deficiency. Zinc deficiency affects about 2.2 billion people around the world. Zinc deficiency in humans results from reduced dietary intake, inadequate absorption, increased loss, or increased use. The most common cause is reduced dietary intake. As much as 25% of the world's population is at risk. Increasing the amount of zinc in the soil and thus in crops is an effective preventative measure. Zinc plays an essential role in numerous biochemical pathways. It affects many organ systems, including the skin, gastrointestinal tract, central nervous system, and immune, skeletal, and reproductive systems. A lack of zinc thus has numerous manifestations, the most common of which are an increased rates of diarrhea, pneumonia, and malaria. Zinc deficiency affects about 2.2 billion people around the world. Zinc deficiency can be classified as acute, as may occur during prolonged inappropriate zinc-free total parenteral nutrition, or chronic, as may occur in dietary deficiency or inadequate absorption. Lactation, alcoholism, old age, and metabolic disorders are associated with zinc deficiency in adults. 5 interventional strategies can be used. Adding zinc to soil, called agronomic biofortification, which both increases crop yields and provides more dietary zinc. Adding zinc to food, called fortification. Adding zinc-rich foods to diet. The foods with the highest concentration of zinc are proteins, especially animal meats, the highest being oysters. Browns, beef, pork, and lamb contain more zinc than fish. The dark meat of a chicken has more zinc than the light meat. Other good sources of zinc are nuts, whole grains, legumes, and yeast. Although whole grains and cereals are high in zinc, they also contain chelating phytates which bind zinc and reduce its bioavailability. Oral repletion via tablets, for example zinc gluconate, or liquid, for example zinc acetate. Oral zinc supplementation in healthy infants more than 6 months old has been shown to reduce the duration of any subsequent diarrheal episodes by about 10 hours. Oral repletion via multivitamin/mineral supplements containing zinc gluconate, sulfate, or acetate. It is not clear whether one form is better than another. Zinc is also found in some cold lozenges, nasal sprays, and nasal gels. Severe zinc deficiency is rare, and is mainly seen in persons with acrodermatitis enteropathica, a severe defect in zinc absorption due to a congenital deficiency in the zinc carrier protein ZIP4 in the enterocyte. Mild zinc deficiency due to reduced dietary intake is common. Conservative estimates suggest that 25% of the world's population is at risk of zinc deficiency. Zinc deficiency is thought to be a leading cause of infant mortality. Providing micronutrients, including zinc, to humans is one of the 4 solutions to major global problems identified in the Copenhagen Consensus from an international panel of economists. Soil zinc is an essential micronutrient for crops. Almost half of the world's cereal crops are deficient in zinc, leading to poor crop yields. Many agricultural countries around the world are affected by zinc deficiency. In China, zinc deficiency occurs on around half of the agricultural soils, affecting mainly rice and maize. Areas with zinc-deficient soils are often regions with widespread zinc deficiency in humans. A basic knowledge of the dynamics of zinc in soils, understanding of the uptake and transport of zinc in crops, and characterizing the response of crops to zinc deficiency are essential steps in achieving sustainable solutions to the problem of zinc deficiency in crops and humans.